What did Dora do with invisible ink and binoculars?
Are we dealing with the Defence of the Realm Act?
You are. Dora, in this yes. instance, is the Defence of the Realm Act. Right. So, and what did the Defence of the Realm Act do with invisible ink and binoculars?
Did it ban
it,
them?
It banned them. I think you share the points. Very good. Absolutely right.
The thing about banning invisible ink is difficult to follow through
with
that.
You put your
it?
Finger on a problem. Absolutely. 1915, the year that the French banned absinthe, was the year of Dora. But what did it introduce, which is rather fitting to our theme here this evening?
Oh, the licensing laws.
The licensing, you're doing well. Points piling up there with you, Phil Jupiter's absolutely right. Introduced licensing hours. Why?
Shift workers.
Yes. Yeah, to get more productivity out of the workers.
In the Second World War, they had to get Veronica Lake to get a haircut. Yeah. Because the ladies who had to work in the factory as well, the chaps were away getting blown to bits. were mimicking her haircut and getting caught in the machinery.
Ooh.
Yeah. You know, she used to have her hair over one eye.
She did, that wonderful blonde wave, the rippling.
She was very weapon. Fit.
She was well fit.
But anyway, all the girls saw I'd like to be like Veronica Lake. Yeah. So they had their hair like that, and then they'd lean over and go.
You're in danger of that happening to yourself, Alan, I have to say.
That's one of the reasons why I don't work in munitions factories.
It's all beginning to make sense. Yes, they also brought in British summertime with Dora.
They came up with summer. They're brilliant.
They came up with summer.
I thought we weren't doing that.
That was different. Bonfires, fireworks, flagpoles, campanology, they were all banned.
Campanology?
Campanology.
Bell ringing.
Oh, I thought it was that again.
No.
Hang on, there's no need to try and arouse us during this.
So that was Dora. It's an interesting example of how governments use emergency measures permanently to undermine civil liberties. Thank God that kind of thing doesn't happen here anymore.